bowing my head in shame.
I lost a follower.
One person decided they didn't want to follow me anymore. I wasn't good enough. I didn't stream enough. I wasn't entertaining enough. I wasn't interesting enough. They don't love me anymore. So I bow my head in shame, for I have lost a kindred, a loved one, a friend. Oh well, life goes on. Hello and welcome to Ouren Ishii and Dark Souls 3. In our complete 100%, well, as close as 100% as I can possibly get on the first playthrough, because you really can't get everything on the first playthrough. Now I'm trying to think of where exactly we are. We got the tower key. We got the Firekeeper's soul. Who dat? Boo, I suck. I do suck. I lost a follower. Oh, I talked, the first time you talk to Patches, he will be over here standing up, and when you come back and he's squatting, talk to him again and you'll get that gesture, which is honestly a pretty funny gesture. The Patches squat. So that's your tea bag when you kill someone in PvP. There's your tea bag move. Yeah, I'm not, you know, enough. My guess isn't, like, if you want to be a proper streamer, you're supposed to stream, like, every day, all day, constantly, and I'm not doing that. But I don't have that many followers. I mean, if people, you know, said, do it more, and I probably should do it more if I want more followers, but I need to be in the mood to stream. Like, I don't want to stream just to stream. I want to stream because I'm in the mood to stream, and because then I'll, I mean, it's not like this is my profession or anything. It's like, I'm just doing it for fun. So, you know. But that would be my guess. I don't think this person was like, oh, he's a dick. Although maybe they do. I mean, I say some pretty controversial things sometimes, but I think maybe, you know, I'm just not on often enough. Like, I should be on every day, and I don't know. Maybe I will someday. I don't know. But it's okay. It's not a big deal. Like I said, it's just for fun. If people follow, they follow. If they don't, they don't. It's cool. So I did a few things offline. Let me see where. I just want to gauge where I am because I've been playing some other characters. All right, Gray Rat's here. And is Gray Rat going to?
Oh, hello, abandoned one.
No. Do I have anything to get rid of? Not really. Now, I did go, well, you will. We'll play some tonight. We'll do some co-op tonight. You're getting close. You still have a bit of ways to go, though. So, while I was offline, I farmed a couple items. Unfortunately, the items I farmed, I can't use yet. But I wanted to have them in case I do decide to use them. I think we're going to have to bump strength up a little bit. The 11 strength is not cutting it in terms of a lot of the weapons I want to play around with. I want to play with the Warden Twin Blades, but they're not strong enough yet. Once we get to a point where we can buy Titanite Chunks, which won't be much longer, I have to get to the dragon area. But once I can buy chunks, then I'll be fine. But I want to play around with this. I also want to play around with the Karthus Curve Sword. Anything that basically has bleed on it is going to be good for her. I also farmed a Falchion, which does not have bleed on it, but I'm thinking maybe I'll put poison on it or something. I don't know. Right now, we got to still stick with the Uchi, because it's by far my best weapon. It's what's going to do the most damage. And right now, health and damage output, I mean, well, let me see here. What is my damage output? 258 is not terrible. Chucks, you need chucks. You need chunks. You terrible speller, you. I need health, I need HP, and I need a little more damage output. What is, am I, my stamina is not great either. Because we, you know, that's the problem with pumping points into luck, is that you're losing points in other things. Like, if you want to play this game and you want to have the least amount of frustration, then pick a stat that's going to raise your attack, which is either dex or strength. You know, figuring that you're not, don't mess with mage builds, pyro builds, faith builds on your first playthrough. I mean, if you need a little extra healing, then you could go faith to the point where you can cast heal, but then stop. Like, don't worry about making like a cleric. But pick like strength, vitality, or excuse me, strength, vigor, and endurance. Like I did on my first playthrough, just three things. Vigor, endurance, strength, or vigor, endurance, dexterity. If you like the faster weapons like the katanas and stuff, just go with those three stats. Pump all your crap into those three. And you'll have the easiest time with Dark Souls. Doesn't matter which one you're playing, whether it's Demon Souls, Dark Souls, Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 3. If you stick with that holy trinity, you'll have the easiest possible time you can have with the game. It's when you start messing around with intelligence, faith, and now luck, which also applies to Demon Souls, that you'll run into a little trouble because you're losing points in those other stats. Like right now, if I didn't have 23 points in luck, my vigor would be a lot higher. My endurance would be a lot higher. So what I think we need to do now... Hey, Mike, how you doing? Welcome back. We've got a couple things we need to do. I probably should level up, too. I have 43,000 souls. Oh, farming that damn freaking Karthus sword pissed me off. Oh, my God. I can't... The Catacombs of Karthus are not a place for a dex build because it's all skeletons and they don't give a shit about slashing weapons. If you've got like a club or a hammer or something like that, they're all fine. I'll get into that in uno momento. But I had to farm those dudes. I was wearing which I actually got a symbol of avarice pretty early in this game, which lowers your HP. I don't have a lot of HP, so I died a bunch of times. I ended up using the ball to kill them most times because it was just easier. And the damn thing wouldn't drop. Finally got it to drop, and of course it takes way more strength than I have, but whatever. So anyway, speaking of NPCs, we have... We did, let me double check if I can find it. I believe we did throw Sigurd his armor in the well. And that's a big one. That's a big step towards keeping Grey Rat alive. Now you can keep Grey Rat alive through patches, but if you're trying to get all the NPCs done, then this is the easiest way, because you have to do this anyway. Before you unlock Irithyll, Boreal Valley. You want to come over here. Yeah, I think I'm pretty sure I did this already. A way I can confirm it. Because he should yell at me if I... Who's this? Willie Wadsworth? Alright. I probably shouldn't be doing this. Ah. Oh, god damn it. Now it's going to take 5 freaking minutes for my damn bonfire to come back. See, this irritates me about PvP. Or co-op. If you try to summon someone, there's so many people playing, which is good. But if you get the unable to summon, it's because somebody already hit it. And then it takes effing forever for your bonfire to come back. But anyway. Sigurd is the easiest because Sigurd or Patches will save Grey Rat. So if you're trying... See, I still can't use it. What are you... Evelyn? Nah. I want to get moving. Okay, cool. If I try that, I'll fail, and then I'll go... We'll get some PvP done at some point. PvP's fun. What do you want from me? You just gotta not be afraid to die, that's all. You know? People are so like, oh my god, I died. Like, we're gonna fight right here by the bonfire. The only thing I'm gonna lose is one ember, which is nothing. I mean, granted, I don't have a lot of embers on this character right now, so I should probably wait to PvP for a while until I get some more. Purchase. Yes, okay, so I purchased the Katarina set, and I threw it down the well. So now Grey Rat, when he asks me, he won't ask me until I reach the central bonfire, which is after that asshole alligator thing, which is probably going to kill me a couple times because I hate that effing thing. So that's done. We can go down into Demon Ruins. We killed the sorcerer dude, but he doesn't have any real stories to tell. I could go over here, but you know what? We'll wait because I don't want to waste souls. Not if you summon someone into your world, you're not going to get ganked. That's why you pull people into your world. If you use a red eye orb, you're most likely going to get destroyed right now because PvP, in terms of invading people, is so one-sided, it's not even funny. I mean, it's always been in favor of the invaded, but now it's to the umpteenth. Like, you show up and they have multiple summons, they'll use a seed, it's bad news bears. We do need to start getting our health and endurance up a little bit, so let's get that done. Alright, is what's his face up here? Did he give me the key to go get that cell key? Underground lift. Yeah, we need to go do that. He's not gonna show up again until we do that. So we'll do that. And then I think we're either gonna go down into the demon ruins, or we will go to Irithyll Boreal Valley of the Damned. Okay, so let's get this knocked out real quick. Tower on the wall. But one thing I found out, I did a little cheat on one of my other characters because I'm just goofing around with it. Where I beat the Dancer at level 17 before beating Vort. You have to go kill the hell is her name? Emma? The woman that gives you the banner? You kill her, you get the basin, you put the basin in, the dancer shows up. You kill the dancer, and you have access to Lothric Castle and the dragon barracks and all that, like right before the dragon slayer armor. And and if you kill the dragons there, the dragon here disappears. I thought that was interesting. Don't you get up, don't, oh, fucking a-hole. Like, they're somehow tied to each other. The ones in Lothric Castle that are burning the bridge are tied to the one that's here. Somehow. I'm not sure how. This is where we want to go. You hate dragons. Well, maybe dragons hate you. I should have made her eyes bigger. And her cheeks shouldn't be as angular as they are. I might have to mess with that a little bit. Hey, buddy. Did you do all this? Did you kill all these guys and plant flowers by their dead bodies? Are you a dark wraith with a heart? He's got the heart of gold. Katana. Yeah, Bloodborne DLC is pretty freaking difficult. I haven't finished it yet. I do want to finish it. I started it a little later than everybody else, and I should have just used a homeward bone, but oh well. Yeah, I mean, it's great if you like are like Lobos and you like making completely freaky characters. Like, if you like making characters that are insanely, like, deformed, then this is definitely for you. But if you want to make characters that are attractive or, you know, nice to look at... I don't know why I pulled this guy, I just felt like it. Eat! Yeah, see, he's still up there. Now, here's a little tip. If you really want the claymore and you can't get it because this guy's being a dick, you can shoot him with arrows or crossbow bolts. It'll take a while, and you won't kill him. You'll get him to around 25% health, and he will fly away. Well, it's a parry, and I'm kind of high level for this guy. He will fly away. You will get a large shard, which is kind of lame, but kind of good. I mean, that early in the game, if you have the patience to shoot him with arrows, getting a large shard is kind of a big deal. But it's not that great, and you don't get any souls, I don't think. But he will fly away, and then you can easily go get the claymore, and there's a soul item over there. You know, if you're that kind of player, you don't mind that stuff. Let's see, what else? Alright, so we got the red eye orb, so that guy will be back. Now, let's see here. Zarya's abandoned tomb. We killed Wolnir. Okay. Alright. Let's go fight my arch nemesis. I hate these things. I hate these things so much. There are certain... It really seems like From Software decided that they were going to make multiple enemies in this game that really effing suck. Like, they're just irritating to fight. Like, they're like, oh, you want us to keep making Dark Souls? Okay, we'll keep making Dark Souls. We'll make these enemies that are insane. Are you also going to do a full walkthrough on Dark Souls 1? I don't know. I mean, that's... I could, I suppose. Anything's possible. Let me concentrate on this jackass. I didn't kill him already, right? I don't think I did. Stop it! Don't lock on. Oh, God! Stay away while he's doing that, because he will hurt you. Oh, I hate them so much. Okay, this guy, what you want to do is as soon as he appears, you want to run up and hit him in the face. You hit him in the face, and you do enough damage to his face, he will then go into a repostable state. I don't know if that's a word, but I just used it. And then you can finish him off. You got to be careful when he falls on his back. He will still hurt you while he's flailing around. But take advantage of his intro when he comes in and he's like, "I'm a badass." Go up and hit him in the face, and you will have good times. If you don't, you will have bad times. Now you can skip him. You can just run. He can't go through the barrier at the end. But the problem there is that he will then show up when you go down there. And you don't want to fight him down there in the water where you're moving real slow. It sucks. It sucks big, hairy, sweaty monkey balls. You don't want that. So hit him in the face. Hit him in the face, parry his ass. If you're a pyro, you can always burn him. He doesn't like fire too much. Okay. Large Soul of a Nameless. I mean, I think these are all regular people, right? Sister Miria. Wander. Soul of a Weary. Now, let me see if the... I thought I was being invaded. I forgot I didn't light the bonfire. I saw the bonfire all dim, and I was like, shit! Let's see if this will work. This place is amazing. This is probably my favorite area in all of Dark Souls 3. It's just really cool. They did an awesome job. Alright, so are you gonna show... Yes, you are. See, we have a summon sign here. Touch sign requesting cooperation. Now, this person must be someone offering help with the alligator, man. Look at this guy. Nice. Now, we want to do this. Which, be prepared, this is not the easiest thing to do. This guy is kind of a dick. But we can handle it. And if I die or if she dies, we can just do it again. It's not like you can fail this. But yeah, I mean, I love Dark Souls 1. And I've done one for Dark Souls 2. And I've done one for this. Or I will have done one for this. I don't know. It's something I'd have to want to do. Look who it is. Good old Creighton. I stopped him. He uses Divine Blessings. He's a complete dick. But still, taking away his ability to use Estus is definitely still a good idea. Man, we destroyed him. Bleed is so good against invaders, NPC invaders. You're welcome, Cirrus.
Thank you for your kind assistance. Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Dark Moon loyalty.
Loyalty to Dark Moon.
I've actually lost that once. I had a character that wasn't... It was a pyromancer, and her weapon skills were a little lacking. I basically made Melisandre from Game of Thrones. She uses all pyromancy. She's got a... one of the weapons the guys in here use, the cinder... something cinder. It's a burning... stick of fire and death. And she doesn't hit real hard with it. She hits hard with pyromancies, but she doesn't hit real hard with her weapon. And Cirrus actually died. But you can just go back and do it again. It's not a big deal. Alright. Alright. Let's hit the town, shall we? Everybody sees these ghosts and they're like, oh. They won't hurt you. They're all set pieces. Best thing to do is wait here. This guy here will get aggro on you. And then wait at the bottom of the steps a little bit. He has trouble hitting you at that angle. Now this guy usually like to run up here. Oh shit. Not good. I'm stuck on something. I was stuck. See that little lip there? I was trying to roll up the steps, and I got stuck on the fucking step. Like, I got stuck on that little tiny lip there. I was trying to roll left, and I couldn't do it. And instead of changing my freaking direction, I decided to just keep trying to roll in a direction I can't roll because I'm stupid. Don't be like me. Hey, at least hey, we've got that, so yeah, that's good. Shut up. You, come here. Come on. Oh, you sneaky bitch. Oh, God, I hate these. If you don't do these guys right, they will F you up, as you just saw. And my low health is not helping. I need more HP is all there is to it. That guy killed me in 3 swings. And they have like a 5 swing combo. So, I'm gonna get manky soon. Yeah. You don't have to point it out. Laugh at me. Come on. It's because I missed that first swing. Come on. See me. Feel me. Touch me. Oh, not again. Not again. Not again. Dick. Alright. Get! Wow. This usually works for me. Because what they want you to do is go after the one that's shooting the magic at you, and then the one on the right comes and wrecks your ass. So I usually try to get to the one on the right and finish them quickly, but that's not happening, and I got manky. That's alright. Come on. Come on. Don't do that. See, look at that. I almost want you to kill me. Ugh. Because that's too much health to lose this to the first fucking enemy. Now look at, he's already given up. He's like, yeah, I don't need to deal with you. Screw it. The one thing you can do is this. These guys, the ones with the swords, like to shield up a lot. And you can actually take advantage of that. Finally. Of course, it doesn't get any easier up here. This is one of the areas where the game starts to ramp it up a little bit. The game's been fairly easy up to this point. I mean, we fought, Vort? We fought Wolnir. We fought the Abyss Watchers, which the Abyss Watchers can give you trouble at first, but then after a while, you realize that they don't have a lot of health, or they don't have a lot of defense. You can actually do quite a bit of damage to them. I want to pull his buddies away from him. Even though this dickhead can still hit you when he can't see you, which I find incredibly cheap. See what I mean? He can't even see me, and he's still casting shit. That was a bad idea. Get out of there, Jesus Christ. Don't underestimate these guys. That's a good drop. That's a good drop. Now these guys, once you have them alone, they're easy as shit. Stay real close to them. Get real close. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. Hit him. Don't RB, RB, RB. Hit and then RB again. Like swing and then let go and wait. You can stagger him out of everything, and the one thing he can do is the stab, but he can't hit you with the stab if you're real close to him. So those fire guys are a bitch with their friends and from a distance, but up close, they're nothing. Triple kill! Lucky me. Lucky me! I hear ya, I hear ya, I know it. You wanna get up here and get to this guy pretty fast, cause we got a little patrol coming, or there they are. Oh, I thought he was gonna do that. Hit. 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 Look at him. He don't know what to do with himself. He's like, God damn it. I can't even respond. Alright, this is where large shards start to, make an appearance in a decent way, which is good because we need them. Now, we're going to be a little cheesy here. There's no reason to fight these guys. I don't think so. I think that's just FromSoft being dicks. Maybe they see through the eyes of their minions. I don't know. Well, they can even do it when the minions are dead, so. No, I think it's just they can just do that. Wow, look at how that's all lit up. All these others are not lit up. I wonder why that's lit up. That's why that's lit up. Now, I don't need to do this. Pull your shield out. Use your shield. You don't have a shield? You don't have a shield? Why don't you have a shield? Why don't you have a Oh my god. That's a cheap ass move. I can't do that. Now I'm gonna maul you. Pontiff Crown! Alright, we'll go do this for completionist sake. I don't have to do this, I don't really want to do this. First thing you should always do, unlock the door. That way if something goes wrong, you can quickly get back here. I don't need that. And I don't need what this bitch is gonna drop. Nice invincibility frames, bitch.
Come to me.
People have really complained about that fire grab. I love it when she does the fire grab. It's incredibly easy to punish. I think people are backing away from her when she does it. You want to do a roll backstab. You want to get behind her and backstab her. Because if you back away, it's got a long grab reach, like in front of her. But it doesn't have a good turn radius, so you can easily get behind her. Now that spell that I just got, if you're a faith build, this is an amazing spell. The first one you get is shitty. This one is sick. You can destroy the dancer with that spell. Or anything that bleeds. Two hits from that, shit. Shit, I don't want to fight two of these guys at the same time. I think I'm just going to run past them. Which in itself is a bit of a risk. I just don't want to fight them. Two guys, I mean, if I could pull, still don't have a decent range, do I? No, it's different in Darkbead in that it's not like a shotgun. Yeah, I'm just sprinting by these guys. It's a, I just have no desire to fight them at all. I'll waste my Estus. I'll get hit. I might die. I don't want to lose progress again. Grab that. Run over here. Grab that. And get the F out of Dodge. It's the spell that those evangelists use when you first go to the Undead Settlement and they're shooting that black swirly thing at you. It's that. But they use the first level of the spell. And the first level of the spell kind of sucks. The second level, however, is insanely good. When you hit Dancer with it twice, the Dancer will bleed and it'll do about 1,000 damage. Well, look who we have here, Henri.
Oh, I thought it might be you.
I'm looking a little manky, I'm sorry.
I never managed to find Horace, but my duty must be done, even alone.
You didn't find Horace because I killed Horace, and I can't tell you that. That bothers the shit out of me. Yes, always for the children.
Please, take this. Recompense for my foolish request. And also a token of protection. May the flames guide your way.
Oh, okay, I forgot to talk to him in the catacombs after I killed Horace, but that's okay. You don't have to do that. If you talk to him in the catacombs after you kill Horace, he'll be standing on the ledge right near where the bridge is that you knocked down. He will give you the Ring of Evil Eye then, but you don't have to do it there. You could wait till now, which is what I did because I forgot. And he'll also give you...
to face your duty alone. I would do well to learn from you. May the flames guide your way.
Quiet resolve. One of the better gestures.
Yeah.
Dark Souls 1 reference. Okay, we are going to go with the nasty ending, or the good ending, depending on your point of view. But I will show you the way to save Henri. But this playthrough, because we're going with, you know, Oren's not the nicest girl in the world. She's got her reasons for being the way she is, but she's not... You know, she doesn't really care about Henri. So, I'm going to show you, but I can't do it. All right, see, this message is telling you. Try attacking. That's kind of a dickish move, because that is a major decision to make. And to just tell someone to do it is not always the best idea. But this statue right here is not a statue. It's actually... one of those dudes from Londor. It's like Yol. It's a pilgrim from Londor. If you attack it, it will die in one hit. It's actually in chameleon mode. It's pretending to be that statue. It'll die in one hit, and it will drop the chameleon spell. But you will ruin Yuria's quest. Yuria will say, fuck you, and fuck off, and disappear. Now, if you want to save Henri... and you want to help Henri fight Aldrich, okay? You do that. You attack that statue, you kill it. Henri will then have a summon sign outside the doors of Aldrich's, of Anor Londo. You can be summoned into his world, help him beat Aldrich, and then he will give you his sword. And in the end, you basically get the same rewards. Like, I will get his sword, I think. Not entirely sure. I know that if you help him beat Aldrich, he'll give you his sword. And I think, yeah, because what'll happen is he will go hollow, or he will freak out. And I'll see him where I fought Horus. I'll kill him, and I'll get his sword. So either way, if you want his sword, you can go either way with it. No, I'm not. Henri is going to join in holy matrimony with Oren. Oren is going to join in holy matrimony with Henri, which means she cannot attack the statue, so she's not going to. Here, if you ever want Dark Moonblade, oh god, I pray for you. Yeah, they do. In most cases, in Dark Souls, in all Dark Souls games, the story doesn't end well for anybody. It really doesn't. You can make the story end well for Solaire, but it's incredibly obtuse. Like, you have to know what you're doing to get Solaire to live. Oh, wait. We want to be human here. Another thing someone noticed that I never did. That's a burning humanity. If you look at the image, it's actually a humanity, but it's on fire. Here's the roster. I believe that's the Dark Moon / Blue Sentinel roster. Although, I'm sure if we look at it, somebody will have 9,999 because they freaking cheated. Cheaters. It's worse on PC, of course. Now, I promise we will switch and view some different weapons when the time comes. But I'm not ready to lower my damage just yet. We gotta hurry up and kill this guy, because here comes asshole. Bleed you out, dude. I'm gonna bleed you out. I'm gonna bleed you out, and then I'm gonna freaking Lloyds, and you're gonna use a divine blessing. But it's still better than letting you have letting you have a divine blessing. Oh, just in time. Oh, I can play that game too, asshole. How are you dodging out of my freaking backstabs, you asshole? Time to bleed you out. Oh my god. Alright, now I gotta wait you out. I can heal now. Dick. There's your bleed. Oh, the Lloyds ran out. Roll off, roll off. I have had him roll off the ledge. There he goes. Bye bye, Creighton, you idiot. Him and Alva like to tend to roll off the ledge a lot. You don't even have to really try to get them to do it. They like to roll around so much, and their pathing is not great, so they like to roll off the ledges quite a bit. But yeah, I mean, you can get Solaire's story to end where he lives and doesn't go hollow and try to kill you, but it's, you have to know what you're doing. No one's going to walk into saving Solaire like, oh wow, I saved Solaire. That's never going to fucking happen. I hate these dogs. I hate these dogs. I hate these dogs. And I had... Alright, killing one of them is good. Look at their faces. It's like just a skull. Hi, puppy! Not really worth it, to be honest with you. One rusted gold coin and some kukri. They do that a lot in this game. They put things in places that you're like, if you're playing blind, you're like, I have to go find out what that is. And then you go find out what it is and realize it was not at all. I still haven't bought a freaking torch. Are you kidding me? What the hell's wrong with me? I'm gonna have to fight all this shit in the dark. Nah. So that's how you get the Dragon Slayer axe. You have to help Cirrus beat him in her world to get him to invade you there. I've played around a little bit with the Dragon Slayer axe. It's not horrible, it's not great. Anything split damage is, you know, a bit of a toss-up. It's gonna work well against some enemies, and it's gonna work like shit against others. Simply because anything with high lightning defense is not gonna take much damage from it. And you gotta be careful. Another blood gem, nice. I need blood gems. Blood gems and poison gems. You gotta watch out. Oh, there she is. She jumped off. Many people have fallen to that. You run over here and that bitch jumps on your head. Don't attack till you see the whites of their eyes. I knew you were coming, so I baked a katana. Yeah, I'm done. Oh, you bitch. She's gonna kill me. Oh my god, I can't believe she didn't kill me. Forgot about her. Don't forget about her. What the hell was that? Got roared at me. Sorry, it's dark as shit in here and I forgot to get a torch. Can I? I can't see shit. Shriving stone, not really worth it. I can barely see. Yorshka's spear. There. Not the best tutorial since it's so damn dark, it's hard to tell what the hell I was doing, but you get the idea. Walk on the rafters, kill the shit. Come here, you. Get stabbed. Get slashed. I can see your eyes! Your evil eye. Oh, you son of a bitch. You should not be able to attack faster than me. Illusory! Crystal lizard! Okay. Tedious. That's all I'm gonna say. Too tedious. If you wanna kill all these guys, kill all these guys. I do want that blood gem. I don't care about all these guys. A couple might follow me down here. I'll kill the ones that follow. Any of them following? One of them is. This guy's persistent. Oh, two of them. Fine. They were so dedicated to dying that they had to follow me. A pyromancy walkthrough? Well, I have a pyromancer. Pyromancy, unfortunately... not the best thing in the world in this game. I have yet to win a PvP match with my pyromancer. The problem is you have to put points into intelligence and faith. Granted, some of the better pyromancy spells don't require faith, they just require intelligence, but a lot of them require both. The black ones require both. They're just not very effective. You telegraph your attacks with pyromancy so much. People easily dodge pyromancies because they can see them coming a mile away. I don't want that. There's two dudes over here that will attack if I go over there. Not hard, but I don't. That's great heal. This is the miracle great heal. So if you're a cleric, miracle faith build, you definitely want to go get that. I don't care. Don't want it. Don't need it. Now again, this is where there's the bridge we came in on. And if you did not fight the alligator dude, he will appear down here. Best to just take care of him while you're up there. I think he's easier on the bridge because, you know, obviously I can't sprint in this. You could fight him, I guess, if you did get in a situation where you forgot or you just didn't want to fight him, then fight him on that land. Or bring him over here. You can actually bring him over here. Fight him here. So you can move. Now, I know there's a bonfire down there, but we're going to avoid that bonfire. It's kind of a pain in the ass. But we need to go see Sigurd. Make sure he keeps our little friend alive. These bitches... are bitches. And bitches get stitches. Come here. Come here, Samara. Oh, shit. I got two of them. Oh, she's gonna spit at me. God damn it. Fine. Burn. No! No! Get away! Get away! No. Stay away! Get back, foul beast! Pain in the butt. Hmm. This will probably be the last, like, walkthrough I do of Dark Souls. I mean, the first one wasn't really a walkthrough. I mean, I didn't finish one NPC story at all. It was a blind run, which Dark Souls, I'm always going to do a blind run first. I personally prefer blind runs to all other runs. Like, I have YouTubers and stuff that I watch that have recorded their play of Dark Souls 3, and they know where everything is, and I just don't really enjoy watching people play when they know where everything is. I mean, even if I like their personalities, I much more enjoy watching people who are blind, don't know what's coming, don't know where the ambushes are. Now, if you do not save Gray Rat, which I know is kind of bad to say because I'm doing that right now, but, you know, I'm not everybody. If you don't save Gray Rat, his body is going to be right over there. He will die trying to loot this place, and his ashes will be in the middle of that Samara pile over there. But we pushed Siegward forward. I shouldn't have drank in that Estus because there's free Estus up here and I'm an idiot. And Siegward is going to save. He doesn't say anything about it, but just having him here saves Gray Rat. Wait a minute. I didn't send Gray Rat yet, did I? Son of a bitch. Hold up. We can't do this yet. It's okay because the Yorshka bonfire is right near here. I can run past all that shit. I wouldn't mind getting another thing so I don't look all manky again.
Speak thy desire, honorable Lord of Hollow.
Oh, I'll show you.
Tell me.
Ah, that's better. We did not send Gray Rat to go loot Irithyll Valley.
Oh, hello. Discovering Irithyll in the Boreal Valley, all in a day's work. If the tales are true, it is home to old moon-worshipping nobles and should be packed with treasure. What do you think? Shall I go and see what I can find? A fine choice. I am Gray Rat the Thief. What I bring back will be worthy of that name.
Not really. Do I have anything to get rid of while I'm here? Not really. I could sell a Pontiff Knight.
Goodbye, Deuced.
I forgot to send him to the place to go do the thing and be the person and steal the stuff.
Good, wasn't he?
Can I? I can do my katana again. Do it. Do it.
Pretty.
Pretty. Yes, pretty.
Oh,
I like how she just loves excrement covered ashes. Here's some poop ashes for you.
Gracious.
Oh, it's fine poop-covered ash.
Let this Ionia.
What do you sell now? Unfortunately, not large shards. She does sell those. You know what? We don't need it. We don't need it. Cirrus!
I have not thanked you for your generous rescue.
No, you haven't.
That dark spirit was one of Rosaria's fingers.
Vile pig.
Fine bastard offspring who lurk in the darkness. My sworn enemies. Fearsome invaders, to say the least.
Yeah.
I would not have made it alone. You have my deepest gratitude.
Well, give me a reward. Oh, thank you.
If you require help on your travels, I offer you my sign.
Cool beans.
Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Now, normally Oren wouldn't give a shit about Cirrus. She would probably be more aligned with Rosaria's fingers, but because we are doing a complete walkthrough, we'll go ahead and be nice to her. Okay, now we can talk to Sigurd. Now, I do believe at this point is when you could also go talk to Patches. And Patches will say something to the effect of, hey, did you see where Grey Rat went? And you go, yeah, he went to the Boreal Valley. And he goes, oh, shit, that little sucker helped me out. And I think it's intended to make you worry, because Patches obviously is someone not to be... Whoa, did you see that? You could actually see... I gotta try to make that happen again. Hold on. Ah, shit. I'm sorry, this is gonna take a second. Unfortunately, eventually, he does. There's nothing you can do about it. As far as I know right now, and I guess because the guide is out, no one has said, yeah, there is a way. From what I've heard, everyone is saying, eventually Grey Rat will die. There's nothing you can do about it. You can push him as far as the archives, and you will find his body in the archives. Now, if you don't either push Sigurd, if you don't give Sigurd his armor in the well, in the Deacon Church of the Deep, or you don't send Patches to Irithyll to help Grey Rat, he will die in Irithyll. Now let's see, I want to see if I can make this happen again. I swear I saw the pilgrim in the back, and I'm hoping I can make this. Sorry for the loading screen, but keep your eye out over on the corner where I showed you where that statue was. Now there's a pillar there. See it? Did you see it? I saw it. You can actually see the pilgrim in the corner when you come here. Cool. Well, it's the little things. All right, we're running past everything. And I gotta buy a torch. That's all there is to it. Not interested. Thank you. Have a nice day. Would you like this pamphlet from the Church of the Latter-day Saints? No, it's okay. Thanks. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Boop. Don't follow me. Alright, now I can talk to what's-his-face. It's not like he even mentions anything about Grey Rat or anything, but just having Sigurd here waiting at this fire is what keeps Grey Rat alive. And like I said, that's the easier option, because if you want to do all the NPCs, then this is something you're going to do anyway. So yeah, wake up. Now, first I thought, yeah, the first time I came here, I actually punched him, like you do with Framp when Framp is asleep. But you don't have to. You just keep talking to him and he'll wake up. Luckily, punching him doesn't aggro him. It doesn't do enough damage, luckily enough.
I seem to have missed my chance, so I, Siegfried of Katarina, offer my deepest gratitude and a little surprise to go with it. It's all yours.
I ain't no damn cleric.
I know. Won't you join me for dinner? I make a fine Esther soup. I've got some stewing right now. Even we undead deserve a little normalcy from time to time.
Mm.
And finally, upon this rendezvous, let us make a toast.
And you basically get two free heals here because there's soup over there, and then he will actually give you some soup.
My sword.
I thought he was referring to the soup in the bowl. We've talked to him again.
May the sun shine.
Boom! He gives you some.
Have you heard? Somewhere, hidden right here in Irithyll, is a deep dungeon.
You don't say.
And even below that, the profaned capital, home of Yorm, the reclusive giant lord. That reminds me, I've a grave promise to keep. Oh, sorry. I'm afraid I've cast a cloud over things. Well, I'm going to have myself a little nap. The only thing to do, really, after a nice toast.
Could you sleep in any of these places in Dark Souls? Like, could you? I mean, I'd have to crawl into a barrel or something. Like, hide. I couldn't just sleep out here. Like, this is fucking dangerous shit. Now, here's what I'd like to do here. I swear that looks like Dusk. But why there would be a picture of Dusk in here, I don't know. So, pull this guy out here. Damn it, fuck that up. It's actually, a lot of people try to roll around that lightning slam. If you just walk behind them straight, you're better off. My first playthrough, I completely missed this area up here. You. I'm not fighting you over there, I'll fight you over here. I was gonna try to set up parry him, but he didn't do what I wanted him to do. Not a good idea. Alright, screw it. Stop being cheeky and just kill him. I used to be able to parry Silver Knights so easily. And for some reason I have a harder time. Maybe because I'm using a medium shield and I should switch to a small shield. That might be the reason. People have been saying that medium shields... There's a much bigger difference between medium shields and small shields in this game than there ever was before. In terms of parrying. Ha, I can keep trying and I'm failing. Don't do it, man, don't do it! Well, target shield or the buckler are the best way to parry anything. I mean, any small shield has a much bigger window. It used to be it was just the buckler. Like, if you really wanted to parry, then you use the buckler because the buckler had the biggest parry window. Now it's basically all the small shields have big parry windows, the medium shields have shitty parry windows. I can do it, like, you see with the knights in, It looked like something dropped down from the ceiling. The Lothric Knights, I can set up parry pretty well with this shield. But these guys, I'm still not... I really have to practice parrying is what it comes down to. And I've never been the kind of guy that feels comfortable using a small shield. Like, maybe I can get into using the target shield, because the stats on that aren't so terrible. The buckler doesn't protect you from shit. I mean, it's literally like, what, like 40 or 39 or something crazy like that. But I've always been a medium shield guy. I've never been a small shield or a heavy shield guy, really. I've never been much of a great shield person. Yeah, definitely. All right. Maybe my least effing favorite frickin' spot to try to navigate. These fucking dogs. See what I mean? They will stun lock you to death. Alright. I'm gonna show you a little trick I did last time. As soon as you get near that guy at the top who's shooting magic at me, two more dogs come. Plus, there's a third dog, but for some reason, the third dog, if you leave him alone, seems to not aggro. But we're going to try a little trick here. Watch the soul meter. Stupid pooch. Dog fell down the hole that the elevator left. Now there should be another dog. Did they both die? I think they both died. Yes, golden glowing poop, or cheese. Oh, that's cheese. It looks like poop, too. Is he the dog by the statue? He doesn't care. Like, he's just like, you leave me alone, bro, I'll leave you alone. And that's just fine by me. That's not cheese, man. That's being smart. That's one of the hardest freaking spots in the game, literally. You've got dudes shooting spells at you. You've got two dogs who could stun lock you to death. You run by and use their own stupidity against them. That's called being smart, brother. Alright, come on. Come out. Come out here. All of you. Out here. Away from your magic chucking friends. So I can stab you in the crotch. Crotch stab! Come together with your... Oh, you're a magic user, you motherfucker! Get out of town! I know there's another one over here. Don't lie to me. You can't lie. You lie, you die. Oh. Eat that. Now, honestly, I think the best way to deal with this room, because this is another room that's a bit of a bitch, is do what I did and pull the melee guys outside, or drop from there down to here, get the large shard, climb the ladder, and bypass all of them. Like, you can literally drop off. You'll take a little damage from the drop off. Then you climb the ladder and run out. Well, roll through those barrels, run out here, and don't even bother with them. That's a perfectly viable strategy. There's nothing wrong with running. Is there a guy hiding back here somewhere? Yeah? Alright. Like, if you ever watch Franz, a German spy, who I love, I think he's fucking great. He plays the game cheese. Like, he cheeses everything. Like, he sees a giant, like, there's a giant over there. He will pull out a crossbow and shoot it with 99 freaking crossbow bolts until it's dead. Like, he does not care. I could have sworn I dodged that shit. Dear buff. Oh my god, I'm gonna fucking die. I hate these guys. When you have low health, these guys are the worst. The fucking worst. Yeah, the only problem with it is it takes a freaking faith stat. Like, you have to pump faith to use it. Alright, now, I did open the shortcut. There. Move it, girl. Move it. Don't fall in the hole. I hate those guys, man. It's like From was like, "You, all right, here you go. Here you go. You wanted a hard game? You got a fucking hard game." Well, it's not even that it's that hard, really, but there's just some areas that are incredibly... designed to seriously just destroy you. And that's one of them. Like, what the hell? How did you hit me? Oh, that door's... Okay, that door's bigger than it looks. Roll. See how easy that room can be? Alright. Let's try this again, safe bitch. Oh, god damn it, you buffed all the way over there. Oh my god, stop swinging for five! You see how many times she can swing that fucking thing? One, two, three, four, five times. And two hits kills me. I hate them. The ones with the shields and the swords don't bother me half as much as these scythe assholes. And I'm not manky yet, but it's gonna be soon. I think at least some of the damage does. Oh, I went the wrong way. You really kind of want to get the drop on them. Like, if you can attack them before they get in their groove, you can stun lock them to death. But the problem is getting them to frickin' getting to them before they get to you. Ah, no rage. Just, irritant. I could run right by her, but now it's personal. I hear dogs. Whew. And usually stairs are your friend. Like, if you could fight things on stairs, it's good. Because if you can stay below them, a lot of their swings will go over your head. Now, come over here, and if you're gonna buff, do it close to me so I can take advantage of it. Gotcha. Still got hit twice, or once. You, put your shield up. Thank you. Oh, you son of a... Put shield up. There you go. That's good. Hello, Tyler. How you doing? Welcome. You die now. You die. You burn in hell and you die. Ooh, I forgot about you guys. Come here. No! Look at that. Look at that. These little manky freaking little shits. Almost do half my health with one attack. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. And a man in my position cannot be made to look ridiculous. Don't do that. Leave me alone. I don't have time for you. I gotta kill this guy. I gotta be real quiet. We hunting rabbits. Swing, swing, swing. Bye-bye. That's good souls, too. 1,800 for a dude that's so easy to kill. If you're looking for souls at this point in the game, and you need a few extra, throw on the Silver Serpent and kill him a few times. I can't complain. It keeps freaking raining, and I gotta mow my back lawn. It's starting to look like a jungle out there. But, you know, can't complain. All right. That is Irithyll Boreal Valley. Let's see. Bunch of weary warriors. 25k! Holy shit! Bunch of nameless soldiers. 15k. I think we need to go back and level. Yeah, I got a bone shard too, so we'll go back. We shall leveling up. I think we're gonna go do Pontiff. I don't see why not. He's right here. And then we might hold off on Aralanda so we can go down and do the demon ruins and kill, did we kill Horus already? I don't remember killing Horus. I don't think it matters, though. Alright, so let's see here.
Welcome home, Ashen. Speak thine.
Level up!
Then touch the darkness within me. Take nourishment from these.
Yes. We gotta start putting points into strength. That's all there is to it. If I want to use half the weapons I want to use, I don't want to. Shit. Shit. I feel weak. I feel weak. All right, Black Blade takes 18. Karthus takes 15. I can use the Morian Blade now, although I think I could use it before. Yep. So Grey Rat is now looting Boreal Valley.
Tis good to see ye in one need.
I need chunks for this. Because of my low health, I've got freaking 20 vigor, 764. I think once I get over this hump, like once I start getting into the back end of the game, this build will start to come through. But until then, I feel like I don't have, I don't have the health or the endurance that I'd like to have. And my damage is, you know, 279. A lot of builds right now would be up into 350s in terms of damage. So that's why I'm thinking of maybe using one of these gems.
Ah, just good, what neat.
Which I can't even do yet because I don't have the frickin' embers for it. See, I want a poison weapon, and I want... Do I not have... I don't have any poison gems. Although, I'm still not inquiring... I have yet to see many enemies that take poison damage, so... I think bleed is the way we're gonna go. But for now, let's go ahead and see if we can take on the Pontiff. I'll summon, like I said, we'll summon one person. I don't think, yeah. Pretty sure there's only one area in the game where you need to summon an NPC to continue their story, and that's the Crestfallen dude. Sultan? Oh, well, you're gone. Oh well. See ya. Like, I should have Blackhand, Londor Pale Shade, another blood. I'm getting a lot of blood gems. I just can't use them yet. Henri should be out here. That should be Henri, right? Yep. Oh, shit. I forgot, I got enemies out here. I better take care of them. You're buffing, aren't you, son of a bitch? You lost me. See, once you get on them, once you get your swag on, I don't know. Don't ask me. I don't know what you like. Pontiff Knight Curved Sword is not bad, except it's got an intelligence requirement, which I actually meet. Now, this should be... That's Londor Pale Shade. Is this... That's Blackhand Goddard, and then that's Henri over there. But we're gonna summon a real person here. Let's just make sure... Kim Jong-un? Meta? Alright, come on. Oh, no, unable to summon. Anna Tavares. Why does that name sound familiar? Unable to summon. I told you. You want to see me beat the game by myself? I have a full playthrough on YouTube that shows me beat every boss by myself. I told you I would be summoning some people for this playthrough just for the fun of it. I don't feel like throwing... This playthrough is 100% completion walkthrough. It's not about challenging myself. It's about getting through the game and showing all the bosses... Or not all the bosses. Where to get everything. And all that good stuff. I've proven myself. Proven my abilities. And I'm only summoning one person. I'm not summoning three frickin' people. So.
Hey!
Hey! Varys, isn't that the guy with his balls cut off? I was gonna. Alright, let's do it. I'm gonna try to bleed the Pontiff. Now I see I need more Karthus Rouge. My ring's good enough? Yeah, my rings are good enough. These buffs look so cool. Oh, she's bleeding them too. Alright, come on, Pontiff. Let's do this. I tried. Oh my god! I skipped something? What did I skip? Dude, he just wrecked me. You know what it was? Because I ran in and tried to be ballsy and parry him on that first attack. Pontiff is a gut check, man. He's one of those bosses that the game's like, okay, you better be appropriately leveled, you better have an appropriately leveled weapon, and you better have your dodges on point, because if you don't, you're going to get your ass kicked. And I just got my ass kicked. Oh, I did that. We did that. You missed that. We helped Cirrus, and we've been invaded by Kraten back on in the graveyard area. Come on, come on. I know you're over there. Ow! Did not need that. Well, I got an ember, so. I forgot to burn the bone shard, too. There, bring Varys back. See, the other thing is that Dex just isn't really my thing. I'm a fucking bitch. I'm way more of a strength build character. Strength build, that's my comfort zone. Is, like, great swords. Not ultra great swords, but great swords. And not as much Dex. So I'm not gonna. I admittedly am not gonna be as good with Dex weapons as I am with strength weapons. What ring? The cat, silver cat ring? I got it. Boom. And the thing with the silver cat ring in this game is that it literally prevents all fall damage. Like, you jump from anywhere, as long as you have a place to land, you will not take damage at all. Come on, Varus. Put your balls on and get in here. Oh, that? We'll get that after we beat the boss. Did that fail? Or Varus was like, screw you, I don't want to help you. Hyper mode? Oh, he looks cool. Let's summon him. On which location? I think he's talking about... If you're talking about what Tyler's talking about, he's talking about that ring down there. Which we'll get, but I just want to beat the boss first. Come on, hyper mode. You better be hyper. He's got the pyromancer set on. People love that yell. Alright, let's try this again. I haven't fought this guy in a while, so my dodges are a little off. And I will not be trying to parry him again. I parried him the first time I fought him blind. I parried him. I keep missing. Wow, he's doing... Don't die on me, hyper mode! See, my lack of stamina is a problem. Oh, he's gonna do his thing. Oh, hit him. Ow. Hyper, get him off me, man, get him off me! I guess 203 is not terrible. Hyper, heal, man, heal! Heal, my brother! Oh, you kill the ghost and he gets way rougher. Wow, I rolled twice. Hyper mode's dead. Oh shit, he's summoning again. Whew. Okay. Whew, okay. Sorry, hyper mode. I rolled twice to get away from that, that slam he does, the fire slam, and I still got hit by it, man. That thing is wicked. I'm curious. Will you actually... Shit. Oh, shit! No, leave me alone! No, you can't hit me through that! No! 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 Go away! Go away! Here, get this ring. No. Can I drop? Can I drop from here? Yes, I can. Oh! That's a little chaotic there. A little chaos. Well, there's your rings. I got the magic clutch and the sun. Right. I like to speak at times. The ring of the sun's firstborn and the magic clutch. Kind of do want to get those souls back. I'm pretty sure the item underneath is just a soul item, but I'll try to get that now, too. Yeah, you just keep walking. You keep walking. Go on! Yeah, that's right. You heard me. Don't fuck with me. Yeah, you just stay over there. You don't need to bother me. Now, shouldn't these guys patrol? Aren't they supposed to patrol? F it. Hey, guys. You mind if I go get those souls? I kind of want them. You don't mind? Okay. Oh, you do mind. You could have said that the first time. Ow. Ow, 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 ow. Okay, hold on. Okay, 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 I get it, you're pissed. Greed kills. That asshole, I'm watching it on the replay, and he's literally just, like, fuck your rolls. Fuck your rolls, I'm just gonna hammer you in the back until you die. You can roll if you want to. If you don't, nobody will. And if your friends don't roll, then if you don't roll with a... Something that rhymes with hill. Or will. Go. I admit that is a cool looking scythe. Alright, where are my souls this time? Where are they? Outside? These guys are supposed to patrol. I don't know why they're not patrolling. He heard me. Dude, what are you doing running in front of me like that? That's irritating. There you are. I mean, it's only 30,000, but I'd like to get them. Oh, you want to cast? Did you want to cast? Oh, did you want to stab me? Oh, did you want to cast? Dick. And now they start patrolling. You sneaky bitch. I just wanted this. Oh, it's something I don't even need. How many swings do you get? Another curved sword. Now, if I was trying to get a curved sword, I would not get them. I've gotten two in a row. Well, not two in a row, but two pretty fucking back-to-back to each other. All right. I think we need to go ahead and allow bad things to happen to us. Because where's the fun in life if you don't allow bad things to happen to you? We're just going to sit down here. We're going to go back to Firelink. We're going to burn our bone shard. We're going to buy another thing to cure, because I know it's totally freaking vain and stupid, but I hate looking all freaking undead and manky. I just hate it. Now I could buy the ring that allows me to look human even when I'm hollow. What would I replace with? Maybe Flynn's? I mean, it's not like my rings are really doing much for me, but you can always get more souls, so I think it's best just to buy one of these. And like, I miss the old days where you just, if you used an ember, you went back to looking human. Hey, buddy, you lived!
Oh, then we're both safe and sound. Thank the gods for that. I don't like getting things so close. I might have died if it wasn't for that peculiar onion night. But in the end,
he's a good guy. You can trust him.
Take a good look. They're sure to be of some use.
Alright, let's see. I probably should buy some embers, but I've got enough now to last me for a bit, so I'd rather use these souls to keep leveling. Target 6. Yeah, part of me is thinking I should just use the damn target shield. Alright.
Goodbye.
Alright. I already had a target shield. I'm an idiot.
Oh, and
I might have started with one now that I think about it. Oh well. You live and you learn. Let's get rid of some of this crap we don't want. Pontiff. Smo's hammer. Yorshka's spear? Don't want it. Don't need a witch tree branch. Don't need the extra. Don't really need a Karthus shield. Don't need Pontiff crowns. Don't need Pontiff armor. Don't need Pontiff leggings.
Goodbye.
Alright, I've got to have some extra regular shards. We'll just pump up the shield with... I don't have shit. Shit.
Brother, like that.
Brother. That's good enough. Screw it. Do I Welcome have home, enough Mr. souls Mark's to speak. Level at all?
Very well. Then Tuphaken up.
Don't you minimize on me, you son of a bitch. Yeah. At least get up to 800 health.
Farewell, Mega.
Alright, so we are going to allow ourselves to be invaded. We are going to welcome the gank. We are going to go to Anorlando. We're going to fight our way up to Aldrich. I don't think we're going to do Aldrich tonight. Today. But we're going to get some more stuff done. We might also go through, depending. Time is, it's 4 o'clock. How long have I been going for? Can I tell from here? I can never tell how long. Eh, it's been about 2 hours. I've been doing these for about 2 hours. Let's get some PvP in. We're going to lose, just so you know. Don't get mad. All right. I'm not a Dex character. I didn't want to do a strength build again for this. I wanted to do something different. All right, we'll get that one later. Let's see how much we can do before we get invaded. I generally get 2 Aldrich invaders, and I would like to get rid of these 2 assholes over here before that happens, but that's kind of hard. Oh, the fucking fire dudes. Come on. Come on, Jon Snow and Captain of the Night Watch, whoever the hell you are. He's such an asshole, I never remember his name. Come on. Come on. Oh, Jon Snow wants to back off? Luckily, these guys don't heal. Oh my god, the damage on that. Come on, I want to kill old man first. There we go. Doesn't he drop? Oh no, he doesn't drop something. Yeah, well, I tell you, you get better by facing the gank. You don't get better by avoiding the gank. And I'm still probably gonna, damn it. Shouldn't be trading with this guy. All right, well that helps a lot. Getting rid of those 2 before the gank comes definitely helps. Surprised I haven't been invaded yet. It's usually pretty quick, like as soon as you come in here embered up, you get invaded. This guy, for whatever reason, never gets up. Alright, well, we should be able to tell if it's happening when we go up here. It's happening. I told you. Doesn't take long. Alright, I can 2-shot these normal guys, or 3-shot them. Those Aldrich are serious, man. They don't F around. When they want to invade, they invade. And they do it quick. Now, the last Aldrich that invaded me kind of pissed me off. Because he was very passive. Like, I met him over here above the water reserve. I'll show you. And he was, like, gesturing and, you know, being cool. Why haven't I been invaded yet? Why is it taking so damn long? Unless it failed. It might have failed. not worrying about the giants. There's still, I forgot a dude. I mean, it's all part of the game. It's, see, what people fail to remember about ganking is that every once in a while, yeah, it's still happening, but somebody's failing or something because they should have been here by now. What people forget about ganking is every once in a while, you know, there's only so many Ouroboros, there's only so many Peeversons. Most of the time when you get ganked, at least for me, I'm going to die. But every once in a while, I beat a gank, and it feels so good when you beat a gank. Like, when you face... Oh, shit. Now, are you going to be cool? No, you're not going to be cool. You're going to come right at me. You got the twin spears from hell. Wow, that didn't hit you? That did. I don't have... You're the parry king, man. Are you trying to parry that, huh? Why are you being all passive now? You don't want to be bled? And yes, I did notice that I've got a another person here. Wow, you heal a lot, man. You heal a lot. You love your heals. Dead. Wow, we have someone with a little honor. Let's go, Mayhem. Okay, I get it, you're honorable. I'm not playing, we're fighting. I'm not playing any goofy fucking games with you. Now, what do you keep pointing for? Come on, let's do this. No, yeah, I go up and then you start attacking me when I'm being fucking... Fine. You're gonna backstab me, I know it. I know you're gonna backstab me, but I'll play your little reindeer games. See, this one's doing the same one as before. I think they want to wait until I get up here and start getting hit by frickin' arrows, and then they're going to start attacking me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play, and then as soon as they turn, I'm going to try to get the hell out of here. Like, I'm curious to see what this person's doing. Like, this is what I think they want. They want me to come up here and get shot by arrows so that they can then take advantage of me being shot by arrows. Yep. Hey, Mayhem. Yeah, I saw that coming. Well, what, you want to use the fucking enemies? Is that what you're trying to do? Like, I didn't fucking know that already? So now what, you're not gonna follow me over here? You're gonna wait until... Tried to parry the asshole. I'm was trying to get rid of these guys as quickly as possible. I had a chance to beat that person down on the lower ledge by the Easterner's ashes. I should have kicked her off is what I should have done. I thought of it as soon as it happened. I was like, I should have kicked instead of attacking. I thought if I attacked a couple times, I'd push her off. But I should have just kicked. She had her back to the freaking edge, and I didn't think of it until it was too late. I'm gonna parry one of these Silver Knights, man. It's gonna fucking happen. I got one kill in, so, you know. And what I should have done with the second one is I should have just went after her. Like, I should have said, screw it, you're pointing. Am I manky again? No, not yet. Screw your pointing, screw your crap. I'm just gonna start hitting you, and you better defend yourself. Although, she probably just would have ran towards the freaking archers, would be my guess. Hey! Don't hide in the corner. So, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna push up to the next bonfire. And get that unlocked. I'm parrying one of these Silver Knights. I don't care what it takes. I'm doing it. And I'm going to stay unembered until I get my souls back because I don't want to lose them. We'll get the shortcut open. We'll get the rest of the goodies here. We got that, which I'm not worried about right now. I don't feel like dying to them three times. Although, surprisingly enough, the one I found on the bridge in Irithyll did not, cause me as much trouble as I expected. Alright, come on, dude. Quit with your fucking arrows. Jesus Christ. You can hit me from there. Alright. Oh my god. Look at me. Look at me. How am I alive? I've got three gigantic freaking arrows sticking out of my ass. Come on. That still didn't fucking work! Oh my god. Maybe I shouldn't be, you know what? I'm gonna stop setup parrying. I should have parried the first hit instead of trying to set up parry. That was the mistake I made. I'm using a small shield, so I need to start getting into the habit of actually parrying the first hit. And I'm not manky yet, but I'm gonna be soon! I'm gonna parry one of these guys. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. I mean, if... The good news is that I've reached a spot now where if I need some souls, I can farm up souls. These Silver Knights, especially the ones where you're trying to get the Concords for the Dark Moon, which I'm not gonna do, because Oren doesn't have any desire to cast spells. I mean, the only reason I'm using two Pyromancies is because I have my character innately starts with two attunement slots. But I don't care about the Dark Moon Ring, and I don't care about the Dark Moon Blade. Dark Moon Blade wouldn't be bad, but I'm not getting her freaking faith up to 30. That's not happening. Get this guy out of the way. Yes! Told ya. Wow, look at that. Look at that. If I was playing a faith build, do you think that would happen? Do you think I would get that drop on like the first or second frickin' Silver Knight I've killed? Do you believe that shit? Oh yeah. It's coming back to me. Look at the damage though. Jesus, I need a dagger. Not parrying that. Better at the stab. And I fucked up the stab. Come on, man. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm starting to feel it. I'm gonna have to spend some time actually hanging here and doing that. But, I can start to feel it a little bit. I've also heard that the Cestus, and I might try this out if I didn't sell it. I don't think I did. But the Cestus apparently has the same parry window. If you have the Cestus in your left hand, has the same parry window as the original Dark Souls parry. So I'll have to test that out too. The only problem with this guy is he doesn't die when he falls off. Let's do this. We're just going to avoid this guy altogether because he's a pain in the ass. Not that I need this shit, but we're just going to point it out. Oh, somebody fell off. Good for me. It was him. Man, a lot of people die up here. I mean, I died up here, so it's not exactly unsurprising. Alright, so we got two more. If we're lucky, we can get one without aggroing the other. Which can be a little difficult, but what we want to do is get this guy without aggroing Arrow Man over there. Mother, see, this is the problem with my low-ass fucking health. Two swings from this guy and I'm dead. My strength build probably had closer to like 30 health at this point. And it's not even like I'm a glass cannon. It's not like I'm hitting incredibly hard to begin with. Yengi was driven from the Great Swamp, however, and I'm Genki. I knew it. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. See, that's the thing, and you get a couple good parries in, and suddenly you think, oh, I got this. You don't got this. You gotta do it for a while. It's gotta become ingrained. It's not something you can just start doing it and just do it a couple times and you're in. I'm in. No, you gotta keep doing it. Keep doing it. I'm making pork chops tonight. Pork chops and applesauce. No, I'm not making applesauce. Although we do have applesauce, I could technically make pork chops and applesauce, but I'm gonna make pork chops and probably macaroni and cheese and a vegetable. Don't kill me. You fucker. Oh my god. 40,000. 40,000 down the damn tubes. You believe that shit? Son of a bitch, these fucking... It's my lack of health, man. And it's not even like I'd buy the life ring, but the first life ring fucking sucks. It's like 20 health. It's not gonna do anything. Like, if I could get a life ring plus 2, that would be... That what I would wear. That's alright. I'll farm those souls back. I just want to get through now. We'll try to end on a high note. Son of a bitch. Whoa! I suddenly doubled my viewers in like 2 seconds! Is this the beginning of my channel becoming a mega juggernaut? I think not. I think not. Alright. 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 Come on, Oren. You can do this. It's not like you're fighting Beatrix. And I still don't think this is as hard as Dark Souls 1 Arch. Oh my god. I appreciate it. Some people come in and out sometimes, it's like weird. A lot of times I have people come in and they watch for like 2 seconds and then leave. It's like, wow, am I that boring? am I that shitty of a streamer? That you can't hang around and give me a chance? Okay. I understand. I just said that these Anarlano archers are not as bad as the first ones, and now you're making me pay for that statement. I understand. I realize this. I understand what you're saying, Dark Souls 3, and I appreciate that you're trying to put me in my place and tell me that I'm wrong. Wow, I made you bleed quick, motherfucker. Whoa, I didn't know you could do that. $3,800. See, that's the thing. Now I'm at a point where losing 40,000 souls is not the end of the world. Not that I would kill these giants in this manner. With these assholes throwing fireballs at me. Because that's not an efficient way to farm souls. But I wanted to get a few back before I go up here. I do appreciate you being here, though, Tyler. Don't get me wrong. I appreciate anybody who... I mean, I have a... It's weird. Like, it's on YouTube, too. I have, like, a couple viewers that consistently watch everything I put up. Like, there's a couple people that really like what I do. But... Oh, my God! It happened again! What the... Alright, I gotta stop healing there. I made the same mistake twice. I'm not thinking. I'm thinking I'm safe behind that pole, and I'm not. Son of a bitch. Oh, what was I saying? Yeah, it's weird. Like, I don't have a lot of followers on YouTube or on Twitch. But a few of the people that do follow, they're very dedicated. Like, they always show up for my streams. They always watch all my videos. So, in some cases, for a very select few of people, I'm doing something right. Just not the majority. But, again, I'm just being myself. I'm not trying to be Toby Turner. I'm not trying to create some kind of crazy character. I may be a little more animated in when I stream and stuff than I am in real life, but for the most part, I'm me. I'm not trying to play a role or be someone I'm not, you know? I've always been a bit of a goofy guy. I've always been a bit of a class clown. I like to think I have a pretty good sense of humor. I'm a bit dark at times. I have a dark sense of humor, that's for sure. Alright, you. Come over here. Fight me away from your freaking... Are you gonna fall? Oh my god, what the hell are you doing? Don't do that. Keep your sword out. See, that's the move I used to parry all the time in Dark Souls. See, I'm afraid to parry now because my damn health is so fucking low. Oh, shit! No! I'm afraid to parry now because I know if he hits me twice, I'm dead. And I would pop an ember. But the problem with popping an ember is that if I die, I lose an ember. So I want that extra health, but I don't want to waste the ember. Okay. Okay. Concentrate. I don't have... I can... The crazy thing is, I have farmed the dudes up there, the two Silver Knights up there, so many times for my faith build to get Dark Moon Blade, that there's no reason at all why I should be having this much trouble. Now, she used Ludwig's Holy Blade, and they are very easy to stagger with heavier weapons. Like, if you're using... any kind of greatsword, doesn't even have to be an ultra greatsword, just a greatsword, you will stagger them pretty much with every hit. With the katana, I can stagger them after about two or three hits. Alright, I have to concentrate. Can I get him to just leave me alone? Yes. Okay. Let's fight, you and me. That's what I gotta do. I gotta come here offline, or not offline, but not streaming, and just parry the shit out of these guys until I get it down. It's basically what I need to do. But see, even after all those deaths and everything, I lost 40,000, I'm already back up to 10. So it's not the end of the world. Now normally, I would just say fuck these guys, but... I want to open the shortcut. I'm paranoid about the archer. Okay. What are you doing, dude? See, look at my health. Not again. Okay, I'm only doing this because I want to get that damn shortcut open. Not that it's a great shortcut, but I still want it open. And I want to point out... Oh, this guy's a spear guy. I'm definitely not parrying him. Although his stab without the lightning on it... I probably could parry. I've died too many times now. And I need to cut pretty soon. So I want to get progress. Alright, so if you drop, I'll show it on the way back. Is there a reason to come down that one? Can't remember. Can you even go down that one? Alright, shortcut open.
Hi, Bones. Hey, buddy. I will go outside, but it's raining again.
We spent a good amount of time outside with my dog the other day. Yeah, see, that's the Dragon Slayer bow and some Dragon Slayer arrows. Definitely a cool bow for a strength build. I don't need it, so I'm not going to go get it, but I wanted to point it out. Yeah, you can't even go over there. I think we've gotten all the shards and everything from over here, so screw that. We're out of here. I'm gonna end this on something cool. So, let me get out of here. And you know what? I might go ahead and leave Aldrus alive for a while, and maybe the next video, I will try to do some PvP here, actually allow myself to be ganked by Aldrich, and see if I can't get a little better. I need some practice with this dex weapon. I also want to try some other dex weapons. Pretty soon, I'll be able to use the Karthus sword. I can probably start trying to use the twin blades a little more. I haven't used them at all. They're not that bad. Let me see real quick. Doing 283 with this. 211. It's not the end of the world. What else have we got? Oh, the Falchion's way too low. 228. I thought that would be less. So if I can get the materials to bump up some of these weapons to a little higher. Again, like I said before, once I start getting chunks, I can really start experimenting with some of the other dex weapons. Yay! We finally got here. Holy effing shit. Let's go ahead. See, this is how I farm these guys. You come up here, you get this guy to come down. Wait right around here. He likes to do that move. You roll, backstab. Now, if you've got a strong weapon, you can just stagger him from here. That's not bad. That's not bad. Do it again. Ah. See, it's almost like I'm so used to fighting these two that I have no trouble fighting these two, but I'm not used to fighting the other ones, and they kick my ass, and they're the same enemy. Like, there's no difference between them, and yet I somehow have a comfort zone with those two that I don't have with the other guy. I just wanted to get that, and let's pay respects. Everybody loves the giant. There's no one who ever played Dark Souls 1 and said, I hate that stupid giant blacksmith. If you are, you're a horrible person. Alright, let's go kill Red Eye over here and get this, because why not? See, that's the attack I used to be able to parry like crazy. Oh my god. See, that's the problem. I missed the parry and I'm effed. Especially with this guy. He hits twice as hard as his brothers. That was way too late. That was way too late. That was all on me. So what I probably will do, we're gonna knock something out real quick before the end, and then before my next stream, I'm gonna farm these guys a little bit to get some of the souls back that I lost, and I'll buy some embers because I want to stock up on embers. Some of the large shards, because this is a good place if you're still low on large shards, and I can actually buy large shards from what's her face now that I have the Eastern stuff. So I'll push everything as far as large shards will take me. All right, where are my souls? There they are. See, if I stop trying to parry this guy and I just fight him like I normally would, try to bait that, get behind him. No, Jesus Christ, it hits me so freaking hard. Oh, it's unbelievable. One swing from this guy kills me. Well, maybe not one, because I blocked. Man, this episode is full of fail. I'm sorry. If you like seeing someone die over and over again, this is your episode right here. See, that's what you want. You time it just right, and you can get that backstab. And then you just maul him to death. And then this guy, you can get to do that. You can do the same. I gotta kill this guy. I can't let this atrocity stand. See, that's one hit, and he takes more than half my health with one hit. Finally. I'm sorry I had to do that. I couldn't let that stand. You know what? I'll do that offline. I don't have to do that now. But one last thing I want to do before I cut for tonight, because like I said, I got to make it's 4:30. I want to take a shower. think the pork chops should be, but I don't want to start cooking yet. There's one more thing I want to do. I want to get unmankified again. Ugh. At least it doesn't... I'm glad at least it doesn't happen the moment you die the first time. Like, you undo the curse and then go get killed and you're immediately hollow again. Like, it takes a few deaths. But it's still irritating.
Speak, I'd honorable.
I should just buy the ring. But then that's a wasted ring slot, you know? Like I said, this costs souls, but you can always get more souls. You can't replace a ring.
Speak, I'd honorable. Our lord and liege. Knowest thou of a youth named Amri? He is hollow and will join thee in wedlock. A fellow of mine guides him at this moment. When the time is ripe, thou mayst make thy salutations. For what lord taketh no vows? Ah, greetings, our lord and liege. Good tidings. Thy spouse is ready. The time is ripe to greet him. The boy awaits thee in the hidden dark moon chamber of Anor Longmoon. So thou mayst a true monarch become. Till we meet again, may the dark sigil guide thee.
All right, then. Alrighty then. Let's just see what she's talking about, shall we? A ring given to Farron's undead legion by one of the Preacher Twins. No, okay, fine. They just had to have an invisible bridge here, but it's so easy. Like, there's really no risk of dying on it. Unlike Cease, you know, Cease the Scaleless's room, or Crystal Caves. That is so short. I've never been a fan of it, even though it looks really cool. But this might be, I don't know, we'll see. It's white. It's not exactly a gi. But it is white. And the boots don't really, see, I don't know. I'm thinking maybe the maiden is better. They never do white well. Should I dress for the occasion, though? Maybe I should dress for the occasion. Yeah. I mean, we are about to be married, so... From Software has the hardest problem with white. Like, the Painting Guardian outfit is white. It's the closest thing to a pure white outfit you'll ever find in any Souls game. The rest of the outfits that look like they're supposed to be white are actually kind of yellow. Like, this is yellow. This is not white. It has white parts to it, but it's not really white. I just lit this one. I didn't sit at it.
Hey, boys.
And the Painting Guardian would be really nice if I could pair it with a skirt. Like, if it didn't have the boots showing and it was just a close, form-fitting dress, it would be perfect. But the fact that the boots show so much, I don't know. Oh, of course. Now watch, I'll probably... Am I embered? I'm not embered. We should probably wait then. I mean, this still isn't bad, it's just the color bothers me. I wish it was pure white. And it's a little too frilly. I know, it's horrible. I'm a grown man and I obsess over the dress my character's wearing. And they have the Eastern armor, which is definitely supposed to look like a samurai to some extent. So I'm not sure why they don't have, like, a prop... What the hell? Did you see that? I'm watching it now. I just literally fell through the floor. Like, I just clipped through the floor. It was a glitch. That was a definite glitch. I just glitched right through the damn floor. I guess you should probably not... you should probably not do any moving around while this thing is spinning, because... I just watched the replay, I'll show you. I fell through... Right here. I came around here while it was spinning and I just went right through that part of the floor. You know, you gotta give From credit. That kind of stuff rarely happens. I'm not moving now, though. Good thing I wasn't embered. I was thinking about getting embered. I would have been a little pissed off if I had lost an ember over that. But it was right here. I came around this corner and went whoop. And the weird part was, is I landed on the steps below. Try it again. I mean, I guess I could. But I want to get down here and get this done. That kind of stuff rarely happens. But I landed on the steps below, and the steps below weren't that far down. But the game was like, oh, that's not supposed to happen. We should just kill you. Hello. I'm here for my wedding.
Welcome, our gracious lord. Your spouse awaits you. You are very near. Please, take the sword of avowal. May you be the truest lord of Lundor yet.
There's no sword there. Well, if they do, you don't see them. They're just freaking like a hood inside a hood inside a hood inside a hood. But they have arms and legs. So you'd think somewhere in there there'd be a face. I don't know. Our old friend. Pay respects. I'm getting married, guys! Let's go get this ring, even though It's about the most useless ring you could possibly find in the game. Next to Life Ring plus one. The Reversal Ring. Ah. Hello, my love. Shall we wed? It's Henri. Henri's my husband. She does look like a proper bride, doesn't she? Three more dark sigils, which now means I had five, I now have eight, which is the maximum amount of dark sigils you can have for the game. And we are betrothed. Honestly, I'm still thinking that the Maiden is the best set so far for her. If I mixed and match a different... That looks a little old. Yeah, see, all those look old and beat up. This is the most like what she wears, I think. Oh, yeah, now this guy's dead, and you get Chameleon. So you don't have to kill that thing in the church in Yorshka's place to get Chameleon. You can get it here. Now, if you killed the Pilgrim, which was that Pilgrim there, in the Church of Yorshka, then this would never happen, and Henri's summon sign would appear outside of the front door, not the inner door, not the fog gate, but the front door of Anor-Londo. And you could then go help him beat Aldrich. It does feel a little weird, and I couldn't repeat it. But it felt like something was not working right there. It is, but you don't need it. You can always use these. This thing's got bird shit all over it. Do 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 do. Alright, guys, we're gonna end it for tonight. Little boy. You shouldn't give kids swords. It's not right. Yeah, I'll just stay here. I'll go human and sit right here. No one will know a thing. So we are now married. We got Pontiff done. I think next we'll at least go through Anor-Londo up here, open the door, kill the big spider thing, get all the loot inside of there. We will probably go down into the demon ruins and get that done, because I've been putting that off for a while now. And yeah, we'll beat the demon boss down there. We'll probably get two bosses in next time. We'll beat the demon boss and we'll beat Aldrich. And I'm probably going to do a little bit of farming just to try to get some large shards. Like I said, I would like to start playing around with some other weapons. I want to also get my strength up so that I can use this, and use maybe the Black Blade. So we'll see what happens. I can't remember, but I might be able to do bleed now and put some bleed on some weapons, so that should be cool. But until then, I will see you next time. Thanks again for watching. Please be sure to like and follow and subscribe. Should I end it on a... Fine, come on. Let's end it with a fight. She just got married. The least she can do is end it with fight. End it on a high note. Let's do it. Oh, we got some claw action, huh? There, yep. Let's do it. Oh, we got some claw action, huh? If you heal, I'm gonna be really pissed. How was that? Whoa, get out of there! He knows how to use that frickin' nifty dodge shit. What is that noise? Is he trying to parry and... Or is that his dodge move? Oh shit! Come on! Over here! Come over here! Do I have Beckon? We're not parrying each other anyway, so... Wow, I heard that hit, but it didn't hit. Again, I heard it hit, and it didn't hit. These little dodge moves, man. Good fight, good fight. Good fight. I haven't been dual wielding in PvP yet. This is the character I'll be doing it with, and I'm now going to reach a point where I can level up the dual wielding weapons so that I can viably PvP. That was a good fight, though. That was fun. I like that. That was definitely a good fight. I'm not used to fighting people who do that little dodge move. And he came close. He is a couple hits away from putting me down. But we got it done. He was cool. He was cool. He didn't freaking use the enemies to his advantage. Not that that's a bad thing. Like I said, I welcome all kinds of invaders. I just think if you summon someone into your world, you're kind of saying, hey, let's fight like a normal fight. Let's not chug. Let's not play games. If you want to play games, use your red eye orb. Fuck with people all day long. Do whatever you want. Use chameleon. Use all the things in your advantage to try to kill the guy you invaded. But when you summon some, when you get summoned in, when you put your sign down like that guy, I'm basically saying, come into my world and fight me. I'm not saying come into my world and fuck with me. If it happens, it happens. But, you know, I appreciate that's a fun fight. That's a good fight. We were evenly matched. It could have gone either way, but we got the win. We got the win. So that'll do it for tonight. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Peace and love. And check me out on YouTube and follow me and like my stuff because I have bad self-esteem and I need it. Resolve. Bye. Wrong button.